Yes, good morning. Today is the fourth part of chapter Molecular Basis of Inheritance. And the next topic is gene expression. As the name indicates, it is a process by which gene express, or gene is the segment of DNA. So when or how the DNA express itself, the mechanism behind is known as gene expression. A gene is the segment of DNA that specify the amino acid sequence of a protein. Gene expression occur when gene activity lead to protein product in the cell. A gene does not directly control protein synthesis. Means gene directly will not the lead to the synthesis of protein, but gene will lead to formation of mRNA, and further mRNA is translated to form the protein. There is a proper mechanism by which gene express. DNA segment of DNA will lead to the formation of mRNA, and mRNA will lead to the formation of synthesis of protein. Now, what is RNA? RNA is the ribonucleic acid. RNA is the single-stranded structure, and RNA contain nitrogen bases, but RNA contain uracil instead of thymine. But all nitrogen bases are similar, that is adenine, guanine and cytosine is similar, but instead of thymine, uracil is present in RNA. There are three type of RNA in gene expression, that is mRNA, rRNA and tRNA. mRNA is messenger RNA which carry the genetic information. rRNA is the ribosomal RNA which lead to the synthesis of protein, and transfer RNA is that RNA which transfer the information from messenger RNA, and it will lead to the synthesis of protein also. Here you can see uracil is present. This is the chain of RNA in the slide. Uracil is present instead of thymine. Now, structure of RNA. There are two processes involved in the synthesis of protein. First is transcription. When the DNA information is transferred to form mRNA, it is known as transcription, and this mRNA information is further lead to synthesis of protein and amino acid. This is known as translation. Transcription makes an RNA molecule complementary to the portion of DNA, and translation occur when the sequences of bases of mRNA direct the sequences of amino acid in polypeptide. Means transcription is a process by which DNA, mRNA is formed from DNA, and translation is a process by which protein is formed from mRNA. Now, genetic code. Genetic code, you can say that DNA form genes, or the segment of DNA is known as gene. Particular DNA will lead to the synthesis of particular type of protein. DNA specify the synthesis of protein because it contain a triplet code. Triplet code means three nitrogen bases combine to form a code. Every three nitrogen bases stand code for one amino acids. And each three-letter unit of mRNA molecule is called as codon. There are 20 types of amino acids, but there are 64 different types of genetic code or genetic codon or triplet conditions are present. And these codes are universal among all living organism. You can see here, this is the triplet state in the box UUU. If the UUU comes three nitrogen bases UUU come adjacent, then it will lead to the formation of phenylalanine. If UUC, it is also lead to synthesis of phenylalanine. UUA, then leucine synthesis will take place. So these are 64 boxes, and these 64 boxes will lead to the formation of 20 different type of amino acids, and this 64 combinations come from DNA. Now, central dogma. Central dogma is the, you can say, flow of information from DNA to DNA, DNA to mRNA, and mRNA to protein. Means the replication process, transcription and translation, these three processes combine to form a central dogma, or the central concept of genetics, which involve the synthesis of DNA to mRNA and mRNA to protein. DNA has a sequence of bases that is transcribed into the sequence of mRNA, and each mRNA will lead to the formation of further a specific type of amino acid. You can see in the slide. This is the overview of gene expression. You can see here the DNA double helix structure will lead to the formation of mRNA, the green one. And this mRNA is further translated to form a polypeptide, that is amino acid chain or protein chain. You can see here, this is again the same slide, DNA to RNA transcription and RNA to protein translation. Now transcription. What is transcription? Transcription is a process by which the synthesis of mRNA take place from the DNA strand. So during transcription in the nucleus, a segment of DNA unwind and unzip, and this DNA will lead to the synthesis of mRNA. RNA polymerase is required during replication. DNA polymerase is required, but during the synthesis of mRNA, RNA polymerase is required, and this RNA polymerase will lead to the synthesis of new nucleotide. Here you can see this is the transcription and the synthesis of mRNA. The double-stranded DNA chain gets unwind, and the polymerase will run inside the chain, and it will RNA polymerase will run inside the chain. And out of two DNA strand, only one DNA strand is used for the synthesis of mRNA. Here you can see in this slide, a single chain is extracted from single strand of DNA. The chain is mRNA. Now, what is transcription unit? Transcription unit consists of promoter gene, structural gene, terminator genes. Here this is 3-5 and 5-3. This is the double stranded structure of DNA. Double stranded structure of DNA contain promoter area, structural area and terminator area. Promoter area is that where synthesis start. Structural area is that which lead to the synthesis of mRNA. And terminator is that area in which termination process will take place, or you can say it will stop the synthesis of mRNA. Promoter is the site where synthesis start. Structural is that area with respect to mRNA synthesis take place, and terminator is that area where synthesis stop. Here you can see the DNA double stranded structure, RNA polymerase, and inside the RNA polymerase sigma factor is there. Sigma factor is the initiation factor, and this RNA polymerase will enter inside the DNA double stranded structure, and it will lead to synthesis of RNA. And this RNA chain will elongate in the second process, and as the RNA polymerase reaches the terminator area, then the RNA chain will be terminated. Here you can see transcription in eukaryote. This is just same as that of prokaryote, but in the synthesis of mRNA in eukaryote, there are some regions in which coding and non-coding sequences are present. Means mRNA contain coding and non-coding both sequences. The coding one is known as exon, the yellow one, and the non-coding is known as intron, the pink one. So intron part is removed from the exon part, and this functional mRNA is used further for the synthesis of protein. Thank you.